Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I can only say that I'm really, really energized to see the kind of energy that exists amongst the youth in Chennai. And I'm very confident that Anna's fast starting from 16th will be very successful if this is the kind of energy that pervades amongst the youth all over the country. I have come here with a hope and with an expectation. A few days back, I was in Mumbai addressing an organization called Young Entrepreneurs Association, which was basically the children of almost the who's who in Indian industry. There was no speech. I started by asking one question, that how many of you are with Anna's Lokpal Bill? And many hands went up. Then I asked, how many of you are with government's Lokpal Bill? Only two hands went up. Then I said, okay, let's have a question answer session. And I was quite surprised that most of the people in the audience had most basic questions about Anna's Lokpal Bill, which shows that the hearts of most of the people in the country are with Anna. People believe that whatever Anna is saying is right and whatever government is saying is wrong, but they don't really know what Anna is actually saying. They know that there is someone called Anna, a very simple man, very genuine man, a fakir, and who is fighting against corruption, who is fighting for some Lokpal Bill, but they really don't know what that Lokpal Bill is about. So after one and a half hours of interaction with them, they were completely with us. So when I started my interaction, their hearts were with us. And when we ended the interaction, their heart and mind, both of it, was with us. The purpose of today's talk is, I want to share with you some of the confusions that the government, I want to clear some of the confusions that the government has been successful in creating in the minds of the people all across the country. They have thrown words at people, and the government is very good at it. Frankenstein monster, threat to democracy, parallel government, civil society representatives, they are not elected, tyranny of the unelected and unelectable. These words they have thrown at the people very repeatedly, so repeatedly that people are confused now. So the purpose of today's this thing is that I want to share with you what is government's Lokpal, what is it that we are asking for, and if you really believe that what we are asking for is right, then I would really urge you to join this movement with your mind and heart. Why Lokpal Bill? Because despite so much of overwhelming evidence of corruption against so many people out in public domain, there is no chance of anyone going to jail. There is no chance of anyone being punished. You would say that already Kalmadi is in jail, Raja is in jail. They are all in jail only because Supreme Court is monitoring all these investigations. Otherwise, CBI on its own would never have taken any action in any of these cases. All our anti-corruption agencies are compromised. Some very well-educated people believe ki kanoon se kya hoga? What can a law do? They are wrong. Laws are extremely important. Myself, Kiran Bedi, Justice Santosh Hegde, Prashant Bhushan, and Shanti Bhushan. We studied all the anti-corruption laws in the last 6 months, and we concluded that our entire anti-corruption system is completely rotten. It is full of internal contradictions. I'll give you an example. CBI, before filing any FIR, before registering a case, before starting any investigation, any case, has to take permission from the same people who are accused in that case. It has to say, take permission from the minister of that particular department. So in National Highways Authority of India, there was an additional secretary level officer. He was raided by CBI. There was huge amount of unaccounted cash that was found in his house. But CBI could not register an FIR because they needed permission from Kamal Nath, who was the minister in charge. And obviously, Kamal Nath did not give permission to register an FIR. despite the fact that so much of unaccounted cash was found in his house. This is the kind of system that we have, where we have CBI, which has the powers, but it does not have, it is not independent, and it has to take permission from the very same people who are accused in most of these cases. Second, we have CVC, Central Vigilance Commission, who has a total staff of 232 people, and it has to investigate corruption in 1,500 government departments, almost 40 lakh government employees. It cannot do that. And it is advisory in nature. In a few cases that it investigates, it can only make a recommendation to the government, and the government has to take a decision whether to take action in those cases or not. So the former Chief Vigilance Commissioner, Mr. Pratyush Sinha, I was talking to him once, and I asked him, sir, in the last 5 years of your tenure, in how many cases did the government accept your recommendation? And he said that whenever I asked for prosecution of that officer, that is whenever he felt that officer ought to go to jail, the recommendation was not accepted even in a single case. Whenever he recommended that the officer should be dismissed from the job, the officers were let off with a warning. So as Mr. N. Vittal used to always say, that corruption is a high profit, low, zero risk business in our country. And that is the reason that we have so much of corruption. We have multiplicity of agencies, but we do not have even a single agency which is empowered and which is independent of the government. Is there a way out? Yes, there is a way out. In Hong Kong, in 1970s, there was so much of corruption that there was a collusion between the police and the mafia. The crime went up very high, and lakhs of students came on the streets, which forced the government to set up an independent commission against corruption, ICAC Hong Kong. You can do a Google search and find out about them. ICAC was given complete powers, they were given complete independence, and they were given full resources. The first step that ICAC took was that there are 182 middle-level police officers, there were 182 police officers. They sacked 120 officers out of that. And a message went all across the bureaucracy that now corruption will not be tolerated in their country. And it is only and only because of ICAC. It is only and only because of ICAC that today Hong Kong is one of the most honest places. We want a Lokpal on similar lines. We have borrowed very heavily from many other countries, the best practices from all across the country, the best practices in our country, and we drafted something called Jan Lokpal Bill. We sent a copy of this Jan Lokpal Bill to the Prime Minister and to Mrs. Sonia Gandhi on 1st December. We did not get any response. And the letter was signed by none other than Anna Hazare, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, Swami Ramdev, people of that Kiran Bedi, people of that stature signed that letter. There was no response. There was not even an acknowledgement from either the Prime Minister or Mrs. Sonia Gandhi. After that, we had series of public consultations all across the country on this Jan Lokpal Bill. We got many good suggestions, and 14 versions of Jan Lokpal Bill have already come out till today. We have incorporated all the good suggestions that we have received. We put it on a website. We have received 3,000 suggestions so far on the Jan Lokpal Bill. So it can truly be said to be the Lokpal Bill drafted by the people of this country. From 1st December to 31st March, Anna Hazare wrote a few letters to Mrs. Gandhi seeking an appointment to request her to accept this Jan Lokpal Bill. There was not even an acknowledgement of his letters. We met almost all the political leaders in this country. We met Mr. Advani, Mrs. Sushma Swaraj, Arun Jaitley. We met Pranab Mukherjee. We met Chidambaram Saab. We met Mr. Moily. We met Prakash Karat Ji. We met Mr. to request her to accept this Jan Lokpal Bill. There was not even an acknowledgement of his letters. We met almost all the political leaders in this country. We met Mr. Advani, Mrs. Sushma Swaraj, Arun Jaitley. We met Pranab Mukherjee. We met Chidambaram Saab. We met Mr. Moily. We met Prakash Karat Ji. We met Mr. D. Raja, we met Mr. Chandrababu Naidu, Mr. Devagoda, we met almost all the top political leaders in our country with the request that please do something. There is so much of corruption in our country. Please do something about it. They didn't do anything about it. So left with no other option, Anna Hazare sat on fast unto death from 5th of April. When he sat on fast unto death, lakhs of people came on the streets. Friends, frankly, we had never expected that there would be such a huge public response to his fast. And the government asked Anna Hazare that you suggest 5 names to be put on the joint committee. So therefore, Anna Hazare suggested those 5 names who had made the initial draft of the Jan Lokpal Bill. And those people were included in the Lokpal committee, joint drafting committee. Now many people are saying that how are you the civil society representatives? You never fought any elections. But we never claimed that we are representatives. We never said that we are representatives. We are very ordinary citizens of this country. We are being looted, we are being robbed. We dared to raise our voice against corruption. Is that a crime? It is the government who invited us to be put on the joint drafting committee. So my request is those who are saying that why are you representing, we are not representing civil society, please go and ask the government why did the government request Anna Hazare to give those 5 names and why didn't the government request any other person to give those 5 names. It is only because Anna's voice became the voice of the people of this country at that point of time. Friends, we entered this joint committee with a great hope, with all sincerity. The amount of research that I did during this last 3 months, if someone sits with me, I'll show you all the rough drafts. We did so much of research on each of these issues. We thought that this was an opportunity, that we'll sit with these ministers and we'll draft a very strong anti-corruption law. But their intentions were not wholly right from the beginning. They did not have good intentions right from the beginning. As soon as the drafting committee meeting started, they started throwing muck at us. Suddenly a CD came out against Prashant Bhushan and Shanti Bhushan. Suddenly they started questioning some land deals of Shanti Bhushan and Prashant Bhushan, which was perfectly correct. And finally, we have 2 drafts coming out of this joint drafting committee, a Jan Lokpal Bill and the government's draft. So we are back to where we were when we started the fast on 5th April. There were already 2 drafts at that time. There was a government draft and there was a civil society draft, and we are back to the same situation. The only thing that we achieved out of the joint drafting committee is that because we were very transparent, we would come out of the committee and we would tell the people that who said what in the committee. And there was so much of public awareness about each of the issues related to Jan Lokpal Bill that every single issue related to this Lokpal Bill was discussed and debated all across the country. I don't think in post-independence India there is any other law which has been debated so much by the public of this country. After each meeting, the ministers used to tell us, please don't go out and tell everything. Just tell them that talks are going on. They're going on very nicely and they're going on in a very constructive and a healthy atmosphere, and we are making progress. But we told them that we believe in complete transparency, and therefore we will go out and we will explain everything to the people. Friends, 5, 6, 7 of us, we don't have anything. हमारे पास ना पैसा है, हमारे पास ना रिसोर्सेज है, हमारे पास ना मैन पावर है, हमारे पास कुछ नहीं है. हमारे पास केवल एक चीज है, वो है हमारी सच्चाई और हमारी ईमानदारी. और सरकार वो हमसे छीनना चाहती थी, हमारी सच्चाई हमसे छीनना चाहती थी, क्योंकि अंदर कमेटी के अंदर जो कुछ चल रहा था, the government wanted that that should remain hidden, that should not come out in public domain. Humne unko keh diya ki hum to sab kuch bahar ja ke sach sach bata denge ki Pranab Mukherjee ne ye bola, Chidambaram ne ye bola, Kapil Sibal ne ye bola, sab kuch bahar ja ke bata denge. Then we said, why don't you... Yeah, I'll do that. There are some... You see, I'm basically a Hindi-speaking person, so when I have to express my emotions, it comes out in Hindi. We demanded that the entire proceedings be video recorded. They should be live telecast. They refused that. We demanded that the entire proceedings be audio recorded and the audio tapes should be made public. They refused to even make the audio tapes public. Because we wanted to tell the people of this country that inside it was just a one-sided dialogue that was going on. We would keep on pleading and pleading before the ministers on each and every point. And they would just announce the decisions. For instance, should judiciary be included in Lokpal Bill? This issue was being discussed. Prashant Bhushan spoke, Shanti Bhushan ji spoke, Justice Hegde spoke, I spoke, and we said that why judiciary needed to be in. And we spoke for almost half an hour and 45 minutes. And at the end of it, Mr. Chidambaram just announced the decision, no, judiciary cannot be in. That's it. Why? He said because Justice J.S. Verma and Justice Venkatchalai are opposing this. That's not an argument. That's not logic. So therefore we wanted all these audio tapes to come out in public domain, that the government does not have any logic when it is opposing any of our proposals. Then we wrote a letter to Mr. Pranab Mukherjee. We said that we don't want these discussions to take place inside a committee room. If you want, we challenge you to come out in any public platform. Let's debate on a public platform. Let it be live telecast to the entire people of this country. The time of your choice, the date of your choice, the place of your choice, and the format of your choice. Shanti Bhushan ji wrote that letter. It is on our website. You can see that letter. Pranab Mukherjee Saab said that the place for debate is parliament, and we don't want any debate in public. Now there are two debates and we need to understand what these two drafts are about. 2 days back, the cabinet of our country has passed a government's Lokpal draft. It has such a narrow jurisdiction that it practically does not cover any kind of corruption. I'll give you some examples. There is so much of corruption in panchayats. So much of ghost works are found in panchayats. However, panchayat corruption is out of Lokpal's purview. Narega, there is so much of corruption in Narega. Narega is out of government's Lokpal purview. There is so much of corruption in public distribution system. Many studies show that almost 80% of 30,000 crore subsidy, annual subsidy, is siphoned off. That is also outside government's Lokpal purview. The medicines in government hospitals are siphoned off. That is also outside the purview of government's Lokpal bill. The roads in cities and villages, they are constructed and they come off within a few days because there is corruption in the roads. That is also outside Lokpal's purview. The municipal corruption, that is also outside government's Lokpal purview. Adarsh housing scam, Commonwealth Games scam, Reddy scam, Reddy Brothers scam, mining scam, Taj Corridor scam, fodder scam, Jharkhand Mukti Morcha scam, cash for vote scam, Yamuna Expressway scam, all this is outside government's Lokpal bill's purview. The Prime Minister is outside government's Lokpal bill's purview. MPs are outside government's Lokpal's bill purview. MLAs are outside government's Lokpal. Sarpanches are outside government's Lokpal. Municipal councillors are outside government's Lokpal. All state government employees all across the country are outside government's Lokpal. All groups B, C and D employees of central government are outside government's Lokpal. What is inside government's Lokpal? The government's Lokpal bill says that if any person will make a complaint to the Lokpal, and if there isn't sufficient evidence in that complaint, then there could be 2 years of minimum imprisonment against that complainant. That is within government's Lokpal. As soon as a citizen makes a complaint to the Lokpal, the corrupt officer against whom the complaint has been made has been given an immediate right to go to the court and make a complaint, file a case against the citizen that he has filed a false and a frivolous complaint. And the corrupt officer will be provided free advocate by the government. And if the citizen is not able to prove his complaint, there is minimum 2 years imprisonment against him. But if he proves the complaint that the officer is corrupt, then there's just 6 months of punishment against the corrupt officer. So friends, this Lokpal bill drafted by the government is basically to target the people who are fighting against corruption. It is not meant to target the corrupt and corruption in the government. It is meant to target those people who dare raise their voice against corruption. As soon as you make a complaint to the Lokpal, or as soon as you make a complaint to any anti-corruption agency, immediately you are targeted, you are threatened, you are victimized. In the last 1 year, 13 RTI activists have been murdered all across the country. The people who dared to file an RTI application to get information from the government. In Jal Lokpal bill, we had suggested that the Lokpal should have a duty to provide protection to such people. The government has not accepted that proposal. So there is no protection of whistleblowers. When we told all this to the government said there are 1.25 crore government employees all across the country. You would need such a huge force of people to keep a check on their corruption. So when the government came to power, they should have realized that they are actually taking the reins of power of a country which is very huge. If there are 1.25, agar sava crore employees is desh mein hai, to unko khula nahi chhod sakte rishwat khori karne ke liye. You have to provide adequate systems in this country. You have to provide. Corruption is a crime. Under law, corruption is a crime. As heinous as murder, as heinous as rape. It is written in the law. So if tomorrow the incidence of murder or incidence of rape goes as much as we have corruption today, will this government turn around and say that we can't provide protection to all of you because there are 120 crore people in this country? What kind of a logic is this, that because there are 1.25 crore people, therefore we can't keep a check on them? Therefore we have provided a Lokpal which will keep a check on only a very small band of corruption, and we'll let loose all the rest of the officers to loot this country. CBI is completely in the clutches of the government. We all know how CBI has been used and misused by all successive governments. Bank account of Quatrochi was defrozen in complete secrecy against public interest because he happens to be close to someone very senior in power. Because CBI is directly in the control of the government. For one full year, no action was taken against Raja. Because Raja was one of the central government ministers, it is only when Supreme Court, the case was filed in Supreme Court, that CBI started functioning. In future also, CBI will continue not taking any action against any Raja. CBI will continue not taking any action against any Kanmadi, because CBI will continue to report to the very same people who are accused in all these cases. The selection of Lokpal. This government has suggested a 9-member committee, out of which 5 of them will be their own people. So effectively they will appoint politically loyal and most corrupt people as Lokpals. The removal of Lokpal. We had suggested that any citizen should be able to make a complaint to the Supreme Court seeking removal of the Lokpal if he feels that he has evidence of corruption against a Lokpal member. The government has written in the law that only government can make a complaint to the Supreme Court, not the citizens. So the government in effect has a control over the selection of Lokpal, they have a control over the removal of Lokpal, and they have a control over the budget of Lokpal, and they have control over the functioning of Lokpal. So just like CBI Lokpal will also be a puppet in the hands of the central government. Should Prime Minister be included in Lokpal? It is being said that Prime Minister sits over very sensitive matters and it would endanger our democracy or it would endanger our country if Prime Minister were brought under the purview of Lokpal. Friends, I dread if tomorrow Madhu Koda becomes the Prime Minister of this country, and it is very likely. In this coalition era, Madhu Koda could very well become the Prime Minister of this country, and the security of this country would be threatened because he will sell the security of the country. Prime Minister is privy to so much of security-related information. So in my opinion, Prime Minister is the first person who should be brought under the purview of Lokpal. Secondly, keeping Prime Minister out of Lokpal is unconstitutional because in our constitution only and only President of India enjoys complete immunity from any kind of investigation. No such immunity has been granted to the Prime Minister. So if Prime Minister is kept out of Lokpal, this law can be easily challenged in the Supreme Court as an unconstitutional law. Should judiciary be brought under Lokpal? The government says that we are bringing a judicial accountability bill, and you will laugh to read the provisions of the judicial accountability bill. The judicial accountability bill says that if there is an allegation of corruption against a judge, suppose there is an allegation of corruption against a Delhi High Court judge, then three judges of Delhi High Court would decide whether to register an FIR against that judge or not. Now the judges with whom you have lunch every day, the judges with whom you sit on the bench every day, those three judges committee is supposed to decide whether to file an FIR against their brother judge or not. Is this going to work? This is the kind of judicial accountability bill that they're proposing. We have been demanding that judicial accountability should be to a completely independent agency. All that we are asking for, we are not saying anything else, all that we are asking for that if today, the system that exists today is that if any judge indulges in any corruption, you cannot even register an FIR against him till you seek the permission of the Chief Justice of India. And in the last 20 years, there have been so many allegations of corruption against so many judges in the country, but none of the Chief Justices of India gave any permission against any judge. It is only in the last 2 years that permission were given only in two cases, in Nirmala Yadav case and in the PF scam case. No other Chief Justice of India, including very honest Chief Justices of India, have given permission to even register an FIR against their brother judges. There is so much of collusion amongst them. All that we have been saying is rather than the Chief Justice of India giving permission, the permission to register an FIR should be given by a 7-member bench of Lokpal in an open hearing. But again, they have not included that. Judiciary has been kept completely out of Lokpal. One interesting question, one of the girls during the debate said that Mr. Kapil Sibal is saying right when he says that Lokpal will be a parallel government. An impression is being given that anything which is not in the control of the government is a parallel government. That is not right. In any democracy, as it was discussed, we have judiciary, we have legislature, and we have executive. And executive has all the powers, all the executive powers. It is almost like a superpower. So in order to keep a check on executive, we created several independent bodies. So therefore, we created a judiciary to keep a check on arbitrariness, injustice, and corruption of the executive. We created judiciary, which is not in the control of the executive. So is judiciary a parallel government? We have CAG, Controller and Auditor General. Is CAG a parallel government? We have NHRC, which is independent of the government. Is NHRC a parallel government? We have Central Vigilance Commission, which is independent of the government. Is CVC a parallel government? We have Central Information Commission, which is independent of the government. Is CIC a parallel government? We have so many other agencies which are completely independent of the government. They are not parallel governments. Likewise, Lokpal will also be independent of the government. How will that become a parallel government? So Kapil Sibal is misleading the whole nation. Another word that is being thrown is Lokpal is a Frankenstein monster. It will come and sit on everyone's head. It's not like that. An ordinary income tax officer Group B officer, an ordinary income tax officer, has the power to examine the income tax return of Dr. Manmohan Singh. He can impose taxes on Dr. Manmohan Singh and he can impose a penalty on Dr. Manmohan Singh. An ordinary income tax officer has the power to examine the income tax return of the Chief Justice of India, impose taxes on him, impose penalty on him. An ordinary income tax officer has the power to examine the income tax returns of all the members of parliament, all the ministers, all the officers. Does this mean that income tax officer sits on the heads of everyone? He does not. Investigating officer of Lokpal will only and only investigate the allegations of corruption against any of these authorities. He will not even have the power to impose penalties or impose taxes. Lokpal will have much less powers than an ordinary income tax officer. But they are trying to create an impression that it is a Frankenstein monster, it is a threat to democracy. Lokpal investigating officer will only and only have the powers to receive complaints of corruption against any of these authorities, examine them, investigate them, and take the matter to the court. That's it. But friends, it is a long, long road ahead. You have already read in the newspapers that they have even denied permission to Annaji to sit on fast at Jantar Mantar. Some of their ministers and some of their colleagues have been threatening that we will crush Anna the way we crushed Baba Ramdev. There is a direct conflict of interest. The people who are supposed to pass this law, if they passed a strong law, half of them would go to jail. And that is the reason you cannot expect a strong law to be passed by this Parliament of India, which has four MPs, serving MPs, sitting MPs, sitting in the jail today for under Prevention of Corruption Act. 150 of these MPs have serious criminal charges against them. Can we expect this Parliament of India to pass a strong Lokpal bill? And forget about Lokpal bill. Can we expect this parliament to even legislate, pass any legislation which is in the interest of the public of this country? So therefore, there's a serious conflict of interest. And unless all the people of this country take to streets from 16th August, there is no hope. Is desh ke sare logon ko sadak ke upar utarna padega. Many people are saying ki, even if all the people come on the streets of the country, how will this parliament pass this law? Friends, agar Egypt ke log Tahrir Square pe aake apni sarkar ko badal sakte hain, अगर इजिप्ट के लोग अपनी सरकार को बदल सकते हैं, ट्यूनिशिया के लोग अपनी सरकार को बदल सकते हैं, हम तो अपनी सरकार भी नहीं बदलने के लिए कह रहे हैं, हम तो एक कानून पास करने के लिए कह रहे हैं। अन्ना हैज सेड दैट इफ एवरीवन इन दिस कंट्री, अभी लक्ष्मी जी सेड दैट just one day students should take an off. I would like to take stretch it a little further. If everyone in this country takes 1 week's off, ek hafta, desh ke naam, ek hafte ki chutti le lijiye, sare students, sare log, nar, nari, men, women, and if you come on the streets of this country, you don't need to come to Jantar Mantar, don't come to Jantar Mantar, wherever, just come on the streets in front of your house, in the park, at the crossings, wherever you want to, with a tricolor in your hand and shouting slogans of Bharat Mata Ki Jai, Inqilab Zindabad. I think within 1 week's time, we can force the government to bow down to the wishes of the people of this country. If एक हफ्ते के अंदर इस देश की संसद और इस देश की सरकार को हम लोगों के सामने झुकना पड़ेगा अगर इस देश के सारे लोग छुट्टी लेके एक हफ्ते के लिए सड़कों के ऊपर उतर आए। दे कैन क्रश वन अन्ना हजारे, दे कैन नॉट क्रश 120 करोड़ अन्ना हजारे। They can impose section 144 on one Jantar Mantar. They cannot impose a curfew on the entire country. Friends, in my opinion, this is a rare opportunity. It's a rare chance that we've all got. If we fail this time, I don't know when will we get the next chance after how many decades. We cannot afford to fail this time. Every one of you will have to participate, and without your participation, Anna will not be able to succeed. Sab logon ko sadak pe utarna padega. There are some programs which have been chalked out. I will just announce those programs. From 1st August to 9th August, we are urging people to go to the villages. Gaon gaon mein jao. Jiske paas time hai. गांव-गांव में जाओ, गांव-गांव में जाके लोगों को इसके बारे में बताओ कि किस तरह से सरकारी लोकपाल बिल उनकी जिंदगी को छूता तक नहीं है, एंड इज अ क्रूअल जोक ऑन द पीपल ऑफ दिस कंट्री। प्लीज एजुकेट द विलेजेस, एंड विलेजेस हैव अ वेरी स्ट्रांग कॉमन सेंस। अनफॉर्चुनेटली द इंटेलेक्चुअल्स आर वेरी कंफ्यूज सेट ऑफ पीपल बिकॉज दे रीड टू मच। The moment you go and tell villagers, they will immediately grasp the idea. They understand it very well. From 9th August, let us start mass burning of this government's Lokpal bill. Have you watched the film Gandhi? The first scene was when the Gandhi is throwing his identity card in the fire and he was alone. We have learned this from Gandhiji, all these tricks we have learned from Gandhiji. Foreign kapde jalaya karte the wo. To 9th August se 16 August tak we will do mass burning of, every day we should do it, everywhere we should do it, all across the country. The government's Lokpal bill should be burnt in masses. From 9th August to 15th August, let there be candle marches every day in the evening, everywhere, all across. August 15th, 8 PM to 9 PM, let us switch off our lights. Ek ghante ke liye. Sara desh agar light off karega, let everyone switch off our light on Independence Day. क्योंकि इस देश की इस आजादी ने हम लोगों को कुछ नहीं दिया, अंधेरा ही अंधेरा दिया। एंड फ्रॉम 16th अगस्त वन वीक ऑफ। सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द प्रोग्राम्स आई वांटेड टू शेयर विद यू। आई कांट टेल यू हाउ मच आई एम एनर्जाइज्ड आफ्टर सीइंग सो मच ऑफ एनर्जी इन ऑल ऑफ यू, एंड आई एम वेरी श्योर कि इस बार तो हम सक्सेसफुल जरूर होंगे। थैंक यू सो मच।
Have you ever seen anyone so unassuming, so simple, yet so powerful like Mr. Arvind Kejriwal? He's an absolute